Autumn in Moldova, and the crops are being taken in. But it is not just corn that is being harvested here. In the remote village of Minjia, we found evidence of the systematic trade in body organs. Again, and again, and again. Up a dirt track and into the home of Andrei and his family. He explained how he was trying to find a way of supporting them on just a few pounds a month when a group of men turned up in the village. The deal, he said, was very straightforward.
They carried out the operation in Istanbul. They said it wouldn't hurt and I'd be home soon. They said people live 27 years without a kidney and they have no problems.
Andrei received about £1,200. Whoever bought his kidney would have had to pay more than £100,000. Staff at the Stalinist relic that is the local hospital have to pick up the pieces. The doctor told me he knows of at least 14 cases in the village for sure, but fears it may be nearer 30. They're very sensitive to cold and disease, and their immune system suffers. They need medical supervision all the time. The allegations get worse. Clara insists she went to Turkey on the promise of a job in a leather factory, which didn't exist.
They injected me, and the next day I woke up and saw the scar. I was so ashamed when I came back that I didn't want to go out.
There are no reliable figures for how many villages in Moldova have been harvested in this way, but Andrei's friend Georges shows a scar which is obviously recent, suggesting the traders have come here more than once. Moldova is the poorest country in Europe. There are rich pickings to be had. Across Western Europe, levels of kidney disease have continued to rise steadily, and so it's hardly surprising that the trade in illegal harvesting of human body organs has continued to be so lucrative. But by any given standards, it must also be seen as an absolute medical scandal being perpetrated across Europe. And people from villages like this have become the victims. Andrei complains of being in pain and of not being able to work as hard as he once could. The money's mostly gone on the house and the family. Not much left now, but an 8-inch scar and a gutful of bitterness. Lawrence Lee, Sky News in Moldova.